नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून. यू आर वॉचिंग अस थ्रू पी एम ई विद्या चैनल, चैनल नंबर 10. आई एम रेणु भट्ट विद यू ऑल. एंड इन दिस स्पेसिफिक सेशन ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव आवर सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश एंड द टॉपिक इज डिस्क्रिप्टिव राइटिंग. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डिस्क्रिप्टिव राइटिंग मीन्स, फॉर मोर डिटेल्स वी हैव आवर एक्सपर्ट विद अस. यू आर मिस प्रियंका शेरावत, टीजीटी इंग्लिश, मेंटोर टीचर, डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ एजुकेशन, दिल्ली. वेरी वार्म वेलकम मैम.
थैंक यू सो मच रेणु मैम. Gratitude for having me in today's session. I would like to welcome our students as well who have joined us today. I wish you all good health, yeah. And I hope we will all have a very fun exploring session today.
Sure ma'am, sure. We'll definitely have. And dear viewers, if you have any query or you want to know more about descriptive writing, what exactly that means, and you can write that as well. So you can call us on our telephone number, that is 8800440559. You can drop a mail also at our email address, that is dth.class10@cit.nic.in. And ma'am, let's quickly begin this session here only, and we'll start with the subjects content. What our viewers and students are going to learn in this specific session, ma'am?
Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, when we talk about language, we basically talk about the four skills of language, which are like listening, speaking, reading, and writing. And it's often been seen that our students don't like writing much. I'd like to ask you, ma'am, do you like to write? Or I mean, when you were young, did you like writing?
Ma'am, I love writing.
Did you enjoy the writing tasks that were given by your teacher?
Yeah, exactly. Even I was a professional writer also.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. But unlike you, a lot of people, even I remember when I was young, I did not like much of the writing tasks.
Okay.
So there are specific reasons behind that. So let us focus on writing. And as Bill Wheeler says, good writing is clear thinking made visible. So that is what we'll be trying to do today. So we will try that our writing skill is developed in such a manner that whatever we write is clearly made visible to our readers. So today we will be seeing what is descriptive writing. We'll try to understand the format of descriptive writing, and we will try and write descriptive writing one or two maybe topics today. That let's move to the next slide and see what do we mean when we say descriptive writing. So before explaining what this means, let's play a small game. I will say a word and you have to visualize it and describe it using your five senses. So like when I say dash tastes like, you think about it and then you have to answer. So students who have joined can write in the chat box, and I would request Renu ma'am to answer on behalf of our students and say out loud whatever word comes to her mind. So ready? Are you ready, Renu ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
So the word is popcorn. And what do you think popcorn tastes like?
Ma'am, it's yummy. It's quite tasty.
Okay, so I have an organizer. This is a visual organizer that I have. The word that I have given you is popcorn, and I have made five columns, each being of one sense. So the first is taste, second is sound, then look, smell, and feel. These are the five senses.
Okay.
So the first word that you said, it tastes like?
Yummy, it's tasty, sometimes buttery.
Yummy, buttery, wonderful, wonderful. So I'm just penning it down. It sounds like, what does popcorn sound like?
Ma'am, it's crunchy. It makes so much noise.
Our students can also write down in the chat box if they have words. So we have crunchy. Any other word?
Although, not right now. Ma'am, if we go back to the taste sensory organ, then we can say salty also. It depends what...
Salty.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's caramel also.
Perfect. Caramel taste. Yes, yes. Perfect. And it sounds soggy at times, crunchy at times. Wonderful. What does it look like?
Ma'am, it looks like bumpy and lots of bump on a particular popcorn.
You are a great learner, I must say. Wonderful. You have nailed it well. It looks very bumpy. It looks cloudy. What else?
Yes, ma'am. Very beautifully you said it's cloudy.
Then what does it smell like? If we can have a word or two.
Ma'am, it depends on the flavor, I guess. It smells nice.
Smells nice.
Yeah. If it's a caramel, it sounds it smells like a bit chocolate and caramelly, and if it's salty, then it's a smell a bit penetrating, you know, something like that.
How does it feel like?
Soft sometimes, and it's soft. Hard also because middle portion of that particular popcorn is hard.
I can totally relate to it, and how bad it feels when that comes in your mouth.
Exactly.
Yeah, I can totally relate to that. So what we did is, whatever words ma'am said, we kind of chalked it down, we kind of penned it down in this organizer that we had. What did we get? We got certain words, and we got to understand what this particular topic is about. How does it feel? We made use of all our five senses, and that's how we get to understand a particular topic when we are talking about descriptive writing. So you see, we have a whole lot of vocabulary to start writing a descriptive paragraph on popcorns. As we have described it in our five senses, we get so many words which we can use them further. So descriptive writing, as the word itself suggests, it kind of describes something. It is like, you know, zooming into your topic and exploring it from all angles. It can be anything. From a person, place, it can be an item, it can be an event or an idea. So whatever the topic is, we have to kind of zoom into it, look at it from all different angles and get words so that our writing becomes descriptive. So we use a lot of rich descriptive languages in it. So we have adjectives, we have similes, we have metaphors, personification, visualizations, and of course the five senses, the activity that we just did. So we basically show it to our readers through our words. We don't tell them, we show them. So that is what descriptive writing is all about. It's all about showing, creating a picture in the mind of the reader. So our writing kind of appeals to those five senses: touch, taste, hear, sight, and smell. As it offers the best possible description. Whenever you see any description, the best possible description that a person could get is out of these five senses, and that is what we try to do. So these are fun exercises, and we may, you know, use many adjectives and action words while writing these. It's like we become a painter for our reader. We paint a picture in the minds of our readers through our words. Our words help them see, touch, hear, smell. And we kind of describe them through these. It's a word picture that we create. And as I said before, we don't tell them our words, we show them what it is. So moving on to the next slide. See, whenever we do something, we should understand what's the purpose behind it. It should be very clear. So students, why is it that we need descriptive writing? What's the purpose of it? Let's try to understand that. What do you think, ma'am? What's the purpose behind descriptive writing? Why do we make our learners, or why do we make our students do descriptive writing?
Ma'am, I guess so that they can also experience the same.
Wonderful. Yes, they can experience it. They have a vocabulary that they have to express themselves. So see, when we talk to people, or like when we express through any medium, our thoughts should be conveyed with clarity. And this is what descriptive writing does. So the purpose is to describe a person, place, or thing in such a way that a picture is formed in the reader's mind. So capturing an event through descriptive writing involves like paying real close attention to the details by using the sensory organs, the sensory things that we have around. It improves their writing by making it more interesting and engaging to the reader. And the person, whoever is reading it, or even when you, for that matter, when you write it, you enjoy it so much. So that whole experience becomes really engaging and enriching. And that is what we want. for the writer and for the reader. That is the main purpose behind descriptive writing. Let's move on to the next slide. And let's understand, why do we teach descriptive writing? And as it stated, it will help students' writing to be more interesting and full of details. It encourages the students to use new vocabulary words. Now, I would like to know how many of our students who are connected with us today have problems while, you know, finding a right word at times. Type a yes if you fall short of words.
Ma'am, here I want to tell you, very sorry to say, as we are not going live on YouTube right now, so we don't have YouTube viewers right now with us in this particular okay. session.
So ma'am, I would request you to reply on their behalf. So
sure, ma'am.
Did it ever happen to you that you were like, you fell short of words and you wanted the right word but you couldn't, you know, recall it? Then
yeah, exactly it happens lots of time, and even I was also very curious to know about this, and I was about to ask you about the vocabulary words. See, we have some certain languages and restrictions while we write, like I write in Hindi and some other person is writing in English. So if it comes to vocabulary, how can we manage with those words if we are not getting a particular word for the exact word?
Exactly.
So, how can we
So, perfect. That's such a valid question. That's such an important and vital question that you asked. See, for that, what we need to do is continuously we have to speak in that language. So, if it's English, you have to build your vocabulary. How would you build your vocabulary? When you speak and when you write. So, if you get tasks like this, where you have to think of what words would fill where, how does it feel like, how does it taste like, how does it smell like? So when you have such a brainstorming that goes in your head, you try to look for new words. And when you look for new words, you remember them. And when you use them often, it goes into your conscious, your daily use vocabulary and your daily use language. And that is how your vocabulary increases. And that is what we are going to do. What we are going to do is, through descriptive writing, we are going to increase and enhance our vocabulary so that writing part, obviously, it's dealt with. Your speaking part would also be improved. So that's what happens.
One has to practice that.
Descriptive writing. Yes, ma'am?
One have to practice that and use that word in their daily.
Exactly. Yes. Practicing and doing it on daily basis is the key. The more we practice, the better we become. So that's what descriptive writing will do it. What will it do? It will build your vocabulary and it will enhance your word bank. And language is all about your word bank. Language is all about vocabulary. If you have the right words, if you have the right vocabulary, you're good at it. If you don't have, if you're falling short of words, you tend to, you know, lag a little behind. So let's work on our vocabulary and word bank so that we are great at writing descriptive passages, paragraphs and stuff like that. So it can kind of help students clarify their understanding of a new subject material also, because what happens is, when you get a new topic, we do not know much about it. How to explore it? Again, we'll go to those senses and we'll be, you know, looking layer wise. We'll go dig a little deeper and try to understand what the topic is all about, and for that we'll get to know new vocabulary. New vocabulary that we've got, we'll put it into writing, and when you write something, it kind of gets registered in your brains. And again, your vocabulary and your word bank gets enhanced. So this is the main reason as to why we teach descriptive writing. So moving on to the next slide,
sure,
it talks about characteristics of descriptive writing. So Renu ma'am, if you can read the first line, what does it say?
Includes many vivid sensory details.
Perfect. So when I say it includes many vivid sensory details, what I mean is that it paints a picture and it appeals to all of the senses of a reader. The five senses, as we've already talked about them before, is sight, hearing, touch, smell and taste. Descriptive writing may also paint pictures of feelings the person, the place or thing invokes in the writer. So it's not only about the senses, it's also about the feelings that's created in you. So feeling is an important part to involve. To make writing easy, we can even use mind maps or five senses graphic organizers. So if I call this a graphic organizer, this is something that is called as a mind map. So when we use such graphic organizers for writing, for students who have problem who do not have a vocabulary, when they brainstorm on such things, it leads to a clearer way of writing. They are more organized and they tend to write better. So that is something that we should keep in mind, students. This is something that you should keep in your mind. You always use graphic organizers or mind maps. Next one, ma'am, the second point.
The second point is good descriptive writing often makes use of figurative language such as analogies, smiles and metaphors to help paint the picture in the reader's mind.
Yes, perfect. So this is what it does. The more figurative languages we use, the more refined it is. Analogies are really wonderful. Similes and metaphors we often use. But how to use it, where to use it, and the way you use it, it kind of creates a picture in the reader's mind. And the vivid and the more clearer the picture is, the more attractive your piece of writing becomes. With that, let's move on to the third point.
Yeah, good descriptive writing uses precise language.
Yes, general adjectives, nouns, passive verbs, they do not have a place in good descriptive writing. So using specific adjectives and nouns and, strong action words to give life to the picture you're painting, this kind of builds your writing. It enhances it. So when you use such strong adjectives and you describe in a little more better manner, in a strong manner, it gives life to your writing, and that is what we have to remember when we are writing. So with that, let's move to the fourth point.
Ma'am, that means we don't have to use unnecessary words in our writing?
Yes, we do not have to use unnecessary words, but at times, what to give it an impact.
We have to make it crisp, right?
Yes. No, it can be crisp, but it should be detailed. So okay. If you want to give it an impact, so you can use it twice and you can, make it a little more, like instead of saying, I saw a dog who had fangs, you can say, I saw a ghostly dog, he had white bloody fangs and stuff like that. You can, elaborate it a little to make it more animated, to make it more interesting. And then you can say something like, bam, bam, the door was banging. So you can use it once. But if you want to, make it more impactful, this is something that you can do. So it all depends how impactful your writing is.
Okay, fine. And then the fourth point is good descriptive writing is organized some ways in organized descriptive. Writing includes chronological time, spatial location, and the order of importance.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So when you're describing a person, you might begin with a physical description that can be followed by how that person thinks, feels, and acts. With that, let's move on to the next one, which talks about the elements of a descriptive writing. Now, this again talks about sensory details. So it kind of involves arousing the emotions of the readers and creating an association with them. So like Renu ma'am just said, should it be crisp? Or can I use, should I do away with unnecessary words? See, if you think those details and if you write it twice or if you explain it a little, it's creating an association with your reader and you think it's necessary, I have to write this twice. I don't want to write bam once, I want to write it twice. So you go ahead with it. Because if that's creating or it's arousing an emotion, okay, what will happen next, what will happen, something like that, then obviously you can do it more because our output should be really engaging, and that is something that we have to look into. Then talking about figurative language, using figurative language is one of the main elements of a descriptive essay. As I've told about it before, similes, metaphor, personification and stuff like that, you can use them. It actually helps make your writing more attractive and appealing. So this is something that we should always think of. Then the central theme. There should always be a central theme to what you're writing. You shouldn't sway away through it. Always remember you have to stick to the central theme. Your language should be precise. Precise language is what you have to use, but it should be impactful. So you can use precise language, but if you want to, elaborate a little more to make it impactful, you can use that. and you have to organize your idea. The main thing, the most important thing that we have to remember always is that we should be very organized. We cannot like start from somewhere and end somewhere else. You have to be very organized, very planned in your head that this is how I'm going to start it, this is how I'll be describing it, and this is how I'll be ending it. We'll be looking at it in the next slide, which talks about, yes, how to write. Now, how to write? We can make use of process approach while writing, as it makes a piece of writing more effective. The process approach basically treats all writing as a creative act, which requires time and positive feedback to be done well. In process writing, the teacher kind of, you know, moves away from being someone who sets students' writing topic and receives the finished products for correction without any intervention in the writing process itself. So this is what the writing of a process approach is all about. So process approach writing emphasizes the steps a writer undergoes. So what would the writer undergo? He's got a topic. What he'll do is he will brainstorm, he will write down his ideas, he'll put everything, all the vocabulary, all the things that he has in it. Next step is he will outline it. He will organize those ideas into a logical sequence that this is how I will be starting, this is how my main thing would be, and this is how I will be concluding. Then what he does is he starts drafting. The writer concentrates on the content of the message. So whatever message he wants to give through that particular piece of writing, he will focus on that and then he will write and build on that. After drafting, he will do a revision. He will revise the write-up. After revising the write-up, there will be a proofreading done. Proofreading why? So that he's corrected the language that he has used, pronunciation mistakes, or he has certain words that he shouldn't use. If he could use stronger adjectives or certain stronger words to make it more impactful, and appropriateness of its use. So to correct the language, to do all of that, a proofreading is done. That is either done by your elbow partner, your partner, or you can even ask your teacher to do it. And then goes the final draft, where the final draft, you kind of, you know, rewrite it and then you present it to your teacher. So this is what a process approach is. And process approach actually helps you become a better writer. So this is what we can do when we talk about descriptive writing. Moving on to the next slide.
Yes, ma'am. Here Here I need to tell you that we are left with 2 more minutes only.
Oh my God. Okay. So as I said, brainstorming. If I give you a topic, what you need to do is you have to brainstorm. So if I say your topic is you visit an abandoned house. So if you want to write on a topic, your visit to an abandoned house, what all words come to your mind, you put it in this mind map that you have in front of you. Let's move on to the next one. Now what we do after putting that, as I explained in the slide that came 2 slides before, how the process writing works. After putting it down in the mind map, we start with the beginning. What can we do with the beginning? We can write lines like why you plan to go, where was it, etc. Then next step is you put sensory inputs in it. I saw this, I heard this, I felt this, I smelled this, and this is what I tasted. Then you share your experience. You try to remember that when you are sharing your experience, you have to paint a picture in the reader's mind. Like I said, the dog has had fangs. Instead of just writing this plainly, you can write the brown ghostly dog showed its white fangs at me and growled at me, something like that, to make it look a little more engaging. Then you have to conclude. In conclusion, you can write in a nutshell, therefore, overall, in short, or you can even write finally, lastly, in the end, as a result. So when we use certain words, it becomes an impressive piece. With that, let's move on to the next one, how to draft it. See, when you draft it, you start
with something
like this.
In a very brief,
like
we want to know, yes ma'am, in a very brief, as we're running very short of time right now.
Very short of time. So this is how we've drafted one. We gave these sentences, 10 sentences to students, and after the draft, let's move on to the next one. There was a student, I made him write it. So this is what he came up with. So he came up some beautiful lines, and this is his final draft. He went through it and he saw if he had any errors, he read it out loud. That's the best thing to do. When you write something, you read it out loud and see if you've made some grammatical errors, are there punctuation mark errors, or some other words that you can put. And after that, the child gave it to his partner. If you can see on the screen, this is what he did. And the mistakes that he did were highlighted and he was helped with them.
Okay.
And after that, he again rewrote it, and that's how it went. So let's move on to the next one.
Ma'am, we won't be able to continue with this session as we are running very short of time. We have to wind up this session here
so,
only. But
thank you so much. Yeah,
really
definitely.
Very sorry.
Thank you so much.
This session was really very interesting and engaging. Thank you so much, ma'am, for joining with us. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
So, dear viewers and learners, stay with us on PMA Vidya channels as we have lot of other programs, phone-in programs also for you. It's time for us to go for a small break. Then we'll back with another live phone-in program for you. Namaskar.